done set 6 o'clock. Can I welcome on to the meeting of the coordinating committee? And can I start with asking for apologies for absence? Got Walter Smith, and thanks to John Salford for present there. Anybody else? And yes, Fraser. Okay. Can I ask any declarations of interest? No. And also ask remind people that they're going to be there, they're not subject to party work. Minutes of the last meeting, which was on the 30th of September, pages 1 to 10. Can you have a look at those who were here? Yes, categories.
Thank you, Chair. On the minutes that deals with the notice of motion with 44 councillors, minute 13, page 3, a slight glitch in the recording. I think I explained it at the time correctly. Happy to hear what I was saying. I was saying that the average number of electors per councillor was what I was talking about, and I mentioned Knowsley rather than Liverpool. And if you wanted me to mention the actual figures, I gave Knowsley as 2524 and Wirral as 3670. But it was Knowsley that was mentioned, and it was the number of electors per councillor.
Okay, I think how many minutes?
Janette. I'm Janette. I went to two of them and what I found particularly useful able to see across everything from the wall, which is exactly what the attitude is, and it is not going to be very isolation, how what pleasure was going to do. So I thought that was really useful.
Dennis, did you have your hand up?
Yes, sir. Yes, thank you, Chair. I too thought it was beautifully chaired. However, obviously,
go on, let me say more.
We did clearly, obviously, make a lot of comments on that, so many of them are reflected here. Obviously, people in the room know that that's not scrutiny unless somebody does something about it. So, I'm just wondering what the process is. To sort of transfer, not just because any comments that are made in the room on either side doesn't necessarily have to be actioned, but just what is the process to move it on?
And that's a discussion I've had earlier with Mike about how we progress this, because it's not just a piece of work that we leave sitting there. Over weeks, months, as we get performance indicators, we'll be looking to see how those pledges are being delivered on. But I think part of the solution is to come back and look at the whole in context again every now and then, and I certainly have no problem with coming back and holding similar events possibly every year, because it's possible idea, and look at each one of the pledges, say how are we measured upon that, and I think that would be a useful exercise. Phil, sorry, do you want to comment on that?
Thanks, Chair. Just really on that specific point in terms of the content of that report has been cascaded to all of the project sponsors and leads for each of the pledges, because they are working on strategies and action plans that will feed into the delivery plan phase, or final delivery plan in February, Christmas. So we wanted to get that out to all those people who are authoring those kind of strategies and reports to make sure as far as possible those points can be taken into consideration.
I think it's very difficult to work out how we would prioritise or put in order or somehow sift through, I think, 163 or 164 bullet points that were listed. I note that on page 37 or page 25 or 26, the next step committee was being recommended to consider the points raised and identify appropriate recommendations to refer to Cabinet, or what was said in the next step section. Would it be that officers would look at the points raised and clarify any of the points in writing, or perhaps deal with any misunderstandings, or place them in context, or see where they fit in with the plan? Now, we have had explanations on the night of many of the projects and the senior officers present, but knowing what happens to them in the sense of whether the Cabinet, now it's got lots of options it's looking at, will look at these and see how they fit in. How do you see it going?
I see the document going in this current format through to Cabinet, because this is the feedback from those workshops. My plan was not for this committee to really change that, because we have to go back to the workshops really, I think, to get approval for that. It's to go forward and then to follow the pledges through, because the most important part of this is not that, it is how those pledges are translated into action. That's where the real scrutiny is going to come in. And so my suggestion is that the focus of our activity now is on how those pledges are delivered on and to monitor them over the periods of time. I'm not averse to the comments being grouped, I don't really see if that would bring anything more to it than I think the report as well, and I thank officers for that. So no, I wasn't planning to change the report today. What I was looking for really was to ask the committee if they're happy for this to go forward now, as the non-executive members feedback from feed it into the consultation, feedback to the club pledges into the consultation, and then agree and thank the officers and the partners and the members of David Rush, and then agree that we will look at these pledges over time. That's my thought, that's my thought.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Just on that, the workshops for partner or support from that person, so something else comes from report to say there's a plan for this to be involved, but actually say it's a scrutiny that comes out of it. It's when we get the business plans that we support the scrutiny. So as this stands, just on that, just going forward.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chair. I would say the same. I went to all three, and I think this is a good synopsis of what we went through. And I think we should agree to send this forward, yeah?
Agree? Okay. Does anybody else want to make a comment? I'll be happy then to, first of all, to thank the officers, members and partners for their input into this process, yes? Did you circulate?
I thought we needed to circulate it.
There were some clarifications, I think, that came up. Officers responded to references to maybe the Wirral scheme and just clarified where that was being run. And there was left a number of comments that was clarified as well on page 23. That's been corrected, and also Councillor Gilchrist's amendments have been corrected, and that's been noted on that out. So with those changes, are we happy to send this report to the
Agreed.
Okay. And we've gone to item 5 on the agenda. And this is a report which asks for us to agree, as we did last year, a common approach to scrutinising the proposals relating to the budget. Gives the dates of the next committee meetings for the policy and performance committees. It also gives us three options to consider in the way that we carry out the scrutiny. One is that time be allocated in the meetings, the hub meeting, one of the hub meetings there to review the budget proposals. To be perfectly honest, with families and wellbeing, that really is not a possibility. The agenda is too big just to do that. Second is to hold an additional meeting with each of the committees in which we could specifically to look at budget proposals. And the third is to hold workshops for each of the committees to look at the ones that relate to those service areas. My suggestion, and I'm happy to be given another review, but my suggestion is that we go for the workshops suggestion and then feedback from the workshops into a chair's report to coordinating committee, and then from there into cabinet on the 23rd of February. And the main reason for saying the workshop is, first of all, it worked very well last year, second of all, wellbeing, it worked very well, and I think the chairs of the committees believe that it worked well, and I know the scrutiny officers felt that it was a good format for including people who weren't necessarily part of a committee who might have had comments or wanted to know more about a particular service or option is in. And also, I think it does, in a less formal setting, I think it does facilitate better discussion, really, to tease out the intricacies of what's included in a proposal. So the recommendation that I'm going to put to committee, and I'll look for a seconder, is that workshops for each of the three committees be set up in early January, and that each chair works with spokes in order to get those off the ground. Secondly, pass that. Does anybody want to comment? Yes,
Paul. May I just ask about the timetable in section 2.3? From the 18th of December, the told president engagement and consultation commences. Yeah. What form will that take? I can imagine that in somewhere like Gilchrist Court, because of the options, there'll be specific meetings with users that start, or perhaps libraries, there might need to be discussions with user groups. There are various things, but without picking any more out, how is it to be advertised? Will there be a common place that citizens should send their views to? Have we thought that
through? I'm sorry, we haven't got to do a lot here. No. It's not a carers event. And you did ask if I would mind if you could. I can't ask that question. No. But I will get Joe to respond to all the members of the committee about the exact consultation. That's not what I'm talking about.
No,
I'm talking about the way that we feed into the consultation as a scrutiny service. But I'm sure that Joe will respond to all the members of the committee and explain fully how the consultation with the members of the public and interested user groups is being carried out. If that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Tom?
Thank you. Just to realise that the budget options and the business delivery plans for transparent budgets are different, but will those business delivery plans be available for those meetings? I think they may have to take a holistic view rather than just separate meetings.
I don't rule this out.